Hey folks, Dave here, and welcome back to my Vault-Tec DLC custom underground vault slash bunker build. I'm back here at Ten Pines Bluff, actually, and I just noticed a gap in this room. But if I look around, as you guys can probably tell, a lot has changed. First up, I've gone through and replaced almost all of the Institute walls and floors with actual snapped vault pieces. Now, this took a while to do because I had to match the shape of the custom mountain that I've created. If I zoom out here, you guys can see it right there, just a couple of glitches poking through. But this has given me the ability to actually project power throughout all the pieces and generally have a more organized bunker. I've also been working on a bit of the backstory for this build, as well as plans for what the different rooms are going to be. So yeah, a lot has been going on offline to prepare us for working on it a bit here in this episode. First up, on our list of changes, The bunker entrance is completely different thanks to one of you guys, actually, and his modding talents. Let's take a look at what the inside of the ranger cabin looked like as of last episode. And this is the custom back of the cabin that I built back in March, actually, when I was first laying the foundations for this build. And it took forever to line up, and it has now been replaced with something much more convincing and much more awesome. This new entrance is thanks to the modding work of Scientision. What he has done is actually used a couple of templates from the actual ranger cabin model, as well as the mounted heads here, to create a secret door that blends in basically seamlessly with the back of the cabin. Now, there's supposed to be a Pip-Boy activator for this door, but unfortunately, my load order is kind of playing havoc with it, and it's not there right now. But in theory, this hidden door will not open unless I activate the Pip-Boy item to open it. This will let Joel actually take a pretty close look at the back wall here without being able to tell that anything is actually a hidden door. Now, what I've got set up right now, as you guys can see, is I've moved this shelf off to the side and I've got this table right here. And right now, because of the lack of the Pip-Boy control for the door, I can just hit it like this and it opens up. And there's the hidden vault entrance inside for the bunker. Now, I still have to move this table using the workshop, but I feel like if this bunker was in full lockdown mode, there would totally be a prop table just right there to hide the doorway. And, you know, anybody can move it, even from the inside, once the door was open. So I don't think moving that table with the workshop is a big deal, and I think that does help to sell the illusion, but you guys tell me what you think. Let me go ahead and take this opportunity to answer a frequent question from the first episode of this Let's Build series, and that was, hey, have you built the vault door backwards? And the answer is no. I actually wanted the vault door to come out in the style of Fallout 1 and 2. I like how it comes out like that, the orange light's going, and then it rolls off into the storage area to the right. And then there's our vault inside. Along with Scientision's awesome work on the hidden entrance itself, he also included a DIA intelligence agency seal for the bunker, which is exactly what I was hoping to add to it, because to me this is not going to be a Vault-Tec build, or, you know, any kind of large vault, because obviously it's pretty small, but instead, I'm kind of seeing this as a hidden communication site, most likely military or DIA run. I think that'll fit in a lot better. And of course, under General Dave's leadership, the Minutemen have moved in to make it their own.
Who do you think actually won the war?
I've also added a couple of red lights that should not bleed through to the outside, especially with some lights outside to overpower them. And a fake terminal to act as the opening mechanism for the door. Now, let me take a second here, guys, to also mention how I do these Let's Build series. if you're not familiar with the castle, which was my previous Let's Build series, what I do in these videos is get an overarching look at the build and give you guys a chance to put input in for how it's going to turn out once it's finished. But I don't do everything here in these Let's Build videos, because I want to save some surprises for when I give Joel the final tour and record the full tour video. Additionally, I have finally added some areas out here to complement the farm, including a guard post, which is a work in progress, of course, and also some platforms for farming. And then I also realized that I had no bathrooms for this settlement yet, and if I'm going to convince Joel that the outside and the ranger cabin and these shacks are the only thing that's here, I've got to have some bathroom facilities, because after all of my settlements have had details like that. So for the outside, we get some outhouses, and that's the first one right there. One final change that I've done on my own before starting recording this episode is I've been working to blend all of the cliffs in with the rest of the rocks. I'm going to go into free cam again and show you guys what I mean. This is how the bluffs are looking right now. Let me hold the camera in place so you guys can see. To me, it doesn't quite look 100% natural just yet, but it's getting there. I'm trying to use different textured rocks to help the bluff and the cliffside actually fit in with the rest of the rocks, like the ones down here. Now, the main hurdle for this that I have to overcome is I do have to use these rocks with the darker texture to completely cover up my bunker. But by adding smaller bits of gray rock on top and on the sides, and eventually down here along the seams of the large dark rocks, I think I'll be able to blend it into the cliffside pretty well. And I've also added quite a few shapes to help just extend that slope shape downhill towards the railroad tracks and make it look like it's actually part of the terrain. And here's a look at what this looked like as of last episode. And as you guys can see, it sticks out a lot worse than what I have now. I think the key is going to be I need to keep zooming out and looking at how the overall cliff shape looks and keep adding detailing along the edges and the seams to just help blend it into the terrain that was actually there. I'm also looking at building a couple of shacks and things like that up under the eaves of these rocks, just to help make it even more convincing that not only was this cliffside here before, but the outside of the settlement and the farming areas are in fact what Joel is supposed to be getting a tour of when it's time for the full settlement tour video. And a lot of what I'm placing now is placed outside of the build area thanks to the power of the Place Everywhere mod. And that's kind of the missing piece that I've been looking for making this cliffside look really authentic. Again, you know, a lot of you guys who are familiar with the game, and especially, of course, familiar with the Ten Pines Bluff settlement, would look at this and say, okay, something's a little bit off here. But I think I'm rapidly getting to the point where I could convince Joel, who's not as familiar with the settlements in Fallout 4, that this is in fact a real settlement and a real cliffside. He likes Fallout 4, but he's not big into the settlements, and he mostly enjoys kind of staring slack-jawed in horror at the creations that I make instead of making his own. So yeah, he's not super familiar with the individual settlements and how they might work. So I think a fake cliffside would be a pretty good way to fool him. I think he's gonna fall for it. Oh, and let me cancel the workshop timeout right there. You guys also suggested that I build the lookout tower down on the ground, detail it, and then just grab the entire piece and move it and place it using the Place Everywhere mod. And that is a fantastic idea. That is exactly what I'm going to do. And thank you guys for the suggestion. That's going to make it a ton easier to actually detail this thing versus having to build it piece by piece by placing individual objects down here in the buildable area and then carrying them up to the top piece by piece. I'll probably build it somewhere right here, just floating, so I can get to it pretty easily. But yeah, guys, that is the plan. That is the new mods that I'm using. And I really think this is going to be a fantastic build once it's finished. I'm already much, much happier with how it's looking. So let's look inside for a minute, and before we start building for this episode, finally, I'm mostly just answering questions and making plans right now, let me show you guys how I've laid things out, at least for now. Okay? So I still have these nice shiny Institute Foundation floors for the entrance to the vault slash bunker. Got our check-in desk right here. I've turned what was a hallway here into a low-ceiling kind of garden plot area. I'm going to add some lights and some plants for us to grow some food inside of the bunker itself. And this was mainly because this low ceiling made it almost impossible to fit NPCs or my character through that hallway. It was just super glitchy. I've also gone in and replaced the old reactor room with a Vault-Tec reactor, which is of course two stories and provides 150 power. This is now the centerpiece of the bunker, and while I still have a couple of trees and whatnot trying to clip through, I imagine that a bunker like this would have a bit of vines and stuff growing up through it after hundreds of years, at least that's my excuse, and I'm covering up the main part of that tree with some junk detailing thanks to a mod. The electricity actually travels all the way through the bunker now, thanks to these vault power conduits. You guys can also see, we have just a couple of areas where some of the rock faces from outside clipped into the walls, and I've just embraced those as part of the design and added these industrial support frames around them. It adds a cool, unique, natural look to this bunker and prevents it from looking totally like a Vault-Tec bunker, which is what I was looking for. So, from the front entranceway here, as we go upstairs, to the left is going to be the men's dormitory, not huge, but a 2x2 tile. Men's restrooms here in the back. And then over here, after we come up the stairs, go this way, and we have the women's dorms, along with their own restroom as well. And a bit of that natural, not really natural, I guess, but non-vault cinder block to help break up the vault walls. I'm definitely seeing a lot of sky, whoops, through the rooftops there, so I'm gonna have to make sure that I go through and seal up any of these holes along the ceiling, because I did not notice a lot of these. That is the women's restroom, and I've placed some just wire detailing that I'm gonna get into exact placement later, but I'm hoping to go through with a bunch of mods that let me place all kinds of static props like piping and cables and all that good, greebles, the small little details that help sell a environment. I'm going to be going through and adding tons of stuff like these wires and other greebles to just make the vault look unique and lived in. Up here on the second floor, I'm still planning on some kind of brick piece right here and a kind of common area, almost like a living room. Not really sure why some of these walls are at weird angles. Oh well. And then finally, to the left of the common area, this back piece right here next to the second floor of the reactor is going to be a shower room, which will just be, I guess, shared and on rotation, because we don't actually have room to have men and women's showers, which makes sense. I mean, this is a pretty small bunker. It's not a huge, massive vault. Now, I'm still looking through the voting on the Amino app, where I asked you guys what should the interior for this bunker be. I'm looking through the responses there, and I think we're leaning towards a combination communications bunker and possibly a ammo manufacturing plant, which makes sense, because if this was a DIA bunker designed to survive the war, they would want good communications and a good supply of weapons as well. To go along with that, I'm planning on making this right here the armory, although I'm thinking about taking out this vault wall and making it just the cage wall instead, just that wire mesh cage, just to be a pretty exposed weapons locker. But it might make more sense to have it in a sealed off room to protect the weapons from the elements and the outside air. And of course you have the cafeteria, and that's pretty self-explanatory. Again, this is all just the framework and the foundation for this build. I'm thinking probably some cooking stuff back here, a few dining room tables, and make this our one-stop shop room for both cooking and eating here in the bunker. I've also managed to take this back hallway, which used to actually end right there, and then right here, and I've lowered a piece down and filled in foundation pieces to create a little extension onto the vault. I used my free camera to look around and realized that I had just a tiny bit of extra stone to work with. Let me go back inside of it here. There's some of the pieces right there inside of the rock pieces. So, realizing that, I have gone in and added this, again, lowered section here, a junction hallway, and then to the left, we're going to have a clinic and surgery, which is pretty awesome for an underground DIA emergency bunker. And then this I'm really happy with. It's still, again, a work in progress, but this, I guess, is going to be the bunker commander's room. Not quite the overseer. This is not, after all, a vault, but a pretty cool looking room nonetheless. And I created a little fake cave on the inside of our large rock pieces with some red lights to help make the room more interesting. It makes it feel almost like a submarine. Move that window back there. And then up here, this hallway connects back through the reactor. And I'm thinking probably some kind of storage for back here. So yeah, guys, it's a small bunker, but it's definitely unique, and I am really excited with how just the framework of it is coming together. There's a lot to build, both inside and out, but the reconfiguring for the Vault-Tec DLC is complete, the plans are in place, and you guys be sure and let me know if I should move forward with the communications center and ammo plant for the bunker. I like the idea, I think it makes sense. But the fun part about these Let's Build videos is you guys get to help guide the build as it goes. Okay guys, what we're going to work on for the rest of today's episode, now that all that planning is out of the way for now, is I'm going to work on this workshop area for our garden plots. Already got the steps in place and the botanist station. It's pretty easy to get stuck right there, but let's start with some lighting. I think probably a couple of these. Ooh, that is bright. Oh, that's a modded light. I think we actually have official versions of those now. No? Well, let's give this a shot and see how it looks over here. There we go. That works better. And then one more right here. Let's put some plants down in the garden plot. Let's see here. We have corn outside. Do some mute fruit. Let's turn snapping back on. Actually, let's just leave snapping off because this is going to be a tight fit. Couple of mute fruit trees. Silt beans. There we go. I also chose this spot for the garden plot because the weeds that are sticking up through the floor blend in nicely with our plants. It is pretty cool that these modded lights have real shadows, although I imagine placing too many of them would wreck performance. That one thought he wasn't getting rotated. Okay. Let me up. There we go. What else do we have? We're out of silt beans. Got just a bit of razor grain. I'll put that back here in the corner. Here we go. Some melon. That looks pretty good right there. Just need to assign somebody to it and hope they can glitch their way in there. What are you assigned to? Don't know. Okay, you. Mr. Red Rocket. You are now on bunker food duty. There we go. There goes the assignment. Let me go ahead and see what else we have for Northland diggers for our workbenches. Okay, that's our botanist table. Already got that one. Brewmaster. Now that feels appropriate for this station in the corner here. I'll have to add some barrels and stuff like that. Butcher, do-it-yourself ammo. Forester, hammer time. Tax collector? Okay, that's kind of awesome. I might have to go put one of those at my castle build. The fishy butcher. Wasteland chef. Provides a variety of prepped food. Wasteland garage. Wasteland mail service. That's really cool. Okay, I might not actually use this, but I'm gonna add it to my communication center for now anyway. Because that's just too cool. Don't know what it actually does, but I think it might fit in. Oh, Mr. Sweeper, happiness rating plus one. Add that right there. Ooh, a gym. The Undertaker. Okay, so that leaves the question, guys. Should I stick with the ammo plant to go with a comm center? Or should this be a whole gym right here in the common area? Hadn't even thought of that yet. What other stations could I put there? I kind of like the botany and the custom brewery kind of just hanging out together. Let's put a couple of mats down. Under OC decorator. Whose icon is most definitely broken. I should probably look for an update. I'll put an extra bucket down. Oh, there's already one there with that prop. Okay, that's fine. Instead, let's go to interior decorations, which I think would be under homemaker. Don't mind me, guys. I'm still waiting on a couple of updates for mods, and things are a little bit crowded right now. Aha! Decorations, miscellaneous, interior. So I think we might have something useful in here as far as like a barrel prop goes. Ooh, an HVAC unit. Could be a good one for somewhere down here. Oh yeah, maybe to help hide some stuff back here in the power room. And of course, gotta have a radio for communicating with the outside from the front security desk. And I've got a telephone out here on this table. I'm going to add one at the front desk as well for calling to open the door from the inside and stuff like that. Mr. Handy. That would be nice for the garden. If a tool rack actually fits well here. I don't think it does. But some metal shelving might, along with a wooden basket for collecting crops. Still haven't seen the drink barrels that I'm looking for. Let's go ahead and do a quick save though. Munitions crate. Now I feel like this would fit in very well in the weapons locker. Drink barrels. Yes! Found it. We've got our Gwinnett barrel. Now produced by the Minutemen. What else is in this section? Some decorative plants might fit in well at some point, but that'll have to wait until I know for sure what this central area is going to be taken up with. Well, that looks like a pretty thriving botany and gardening and brewing area. Let's make sure that none of the lights are actually bleeding through. That looks pretty good, guys. So I think what I'm going to work on next... Let's do the commander's room. This is going to be a fun one because I want to start out by fixing some of these lights first. Okay. I'm actually using these red lights because they don't cast a whole lot of light, but they look pretty cool. I don't want them to bleed through to the outside no matter what. There we go. I think actually under Northland Diggers, they've got some stuff you can build now, which is... decorations, potted plants and trees. Oh, that's cool. All kinds of potted plants. Ha! Mushrooms. Really sell that weird cave vibe. That is basically just as I imagined it, guys. That's awesome. Okay, I think it's time to put the window on and consider our cave complete, except for it is a bit dark in there. Well, again, I don't want light to bleed through the rock to the outside. But maybe I can get just a slightly brighter light. Well, I had it there for a second. Okay, I'll leave that one. Make another save right there. What do we have for miscellaneous lights? Not candles, because I want this to be inside of the cave. Let's see how this point light looks. Better, for sure. The only question being, of course, how does it look from the outside? And how do I move it? That stupid fern is blocking it. Okay. Oop, let's not take the corner out there. Fern, I want you to go back here somewhere. Turn snapping back off. Thanks to place everywhere. I'm not sure if there would actually be a bare light bulb back there, but I'm not sure what options I actually have for cage lights. There's those. Oh, the cage wall light. How bright is that? Pretty bright. Let's move you back here for now. That looks like it would actually be underground, though. Okay, yeah, that's pretty cool. Putting our window back. Snap. Snap. Now this reminds me of BioShock right here. I may add one more red light in there just because now it looks off to have one red and one white, but you guys get the idea. I like that a lot. Does it bleed through? Looking outside the mountain here, I don't think it does, especially if I freeze time to roughly this point of day right here, or this time of day, so that the sun is actually shining from this direction. That'll help hide some of this, but also the fact that a lot of these rocks, okay, let me clip inside the rocks right here. A lot of these smaller rocks are helping to kind of stop the light. So that worked out. Okay. A lot of this room is going to be decided by how much space the bed takes up. As you guys can see, I've got some brick foundations here that were the base of these rooms over here. Got some light bleed right there. I'll deal with that later. Anyway, so because of this brick section, we actually have a natural shelf we can use. I want to try and fit the bed somewhere that looks good in comparison to that. And this will probably be a larger, nicer bed if it can just fit. Now that is a pretty cool view for a bunker right there. As you can see, I've got the little American flag here. I'll move that over here to this corner. I don't think there's room for a desk in here. Yeah, it's just such tight quarters. And yeah, we don't have enough room to go any further because of the next wall section. Oh. Okay, that got me dizzy right there. Sorry about that, guys. Going from the free cam back into the workshop mode is definitely dizzying. Miscellaneous, we got some cabinets. I got the overseer's desk. Got a side table here. Oh, and our dining tables. Let's go ahead and place two of those while I'm thinking about it. My menu's gotten kind of overgrown because the Vault-Tec DLC added a bunch of objects that were also a part of mods like Homemaker. It's literally the exact same props from the files of the game, like the vault tables and stuff like that. Okay. That small desk. I want to say that I could find a way to make that work. Oh, yeah. Completely. This is like submarine style quarters right here. Every inch counts. Now for chairs. Got a couple different barber chairs. I want an office chair that takes up not too much space, but still looks pretty commanding, and I think that's it right there. Now what could go on that wall section? I feel like it would have to be some kind of reminder of who this commander was fighting for. So probably a patriotic painting. From before the war. I don't know about Washington. Or it very well could be a modern painting. That kind of fits too. I'm gonna hide that light. I need to also hide this non-clipped spot right here with some kind of air conditioning something up there. Yeah, let's go with a patriotic painting. I think one modern is enough, but I do like how it fits. I'll actually use one of my own from the Minutemen morale mod. Do a Minutemen painting. Wow, that's a big painting. Or, I guess, a small room, too. And of course, got to have a flag on the wall. We'll do the Minutemen. And I'll have some American flags. And I'll put some American flags out here in the common area. Probably not a lot of bunting though, because it takes up so much space. Now we're talking. So, where does that leave us for decorations? Not a whole lot of room for furniture. I think the highlight of this room is definitely going to be the view of the cave. I might be able to get one more end table in there. I guess we also need our primary light as well. Ceiling lights. Where's the Vault-Tec ones? One of my light categories might be somewhere it's not supposed to be. Oh well. Well, that is not at all what I wanted to spend my resources on. That cost me... Okay, only 2 copper. That's not terrible. A table lamp. That seems like something that a base commander would actually have. A nice table lamp. Here we go. Classic ceiling light. Actually, with that ceiling light, we don't really need the table lamp. I don't want to go too crazy with lights. So I'm going to leave it right there. I am going to go back to decorations and then... Ooh, vault. Vault signs. Oh yeah, I forgot about these. Huh. I should have gone around and added these to the rooms. I totally forgot these existed. Now I've also lost my complete train of thought. What was I working on? I was going towards interior for something. Oh, I know. I was going to cover up that gap in the ceiling of the commander's room. Oh, that's so cool. Residential. Do these light up? No. Security. Hydroponics. Ah, this is really cool, guys. I'm not gonna do all these right now. But these are definitely getting added to the entire bunker. They even have the arrows. Okay, that's cool. Well, you guys see where that's going. I'm sure I'll have those in place by next time. Let's put our last touches on the commander's office. America lives on in you poster. And let's see. Surface never. Got some miscellaneous equipment. Stuff like this might also be good for the reactor room. Just to add detail. That's not, of course, any final placement for in here. I'm just placing these down so I can arrange them later, because as you guys have already seen, my workshop categories are a bit out of control, and it's very easy to get lost. Speaking of getting lost, here we go. Greebles. Oh, this is what I'm talking about. All these cool pipes and stuff like this. That's really gonna make the build look awesome. What I'm looking for right now, though, is not tugboats, but rather some kind of machinery object that can cover up that weird gap in the ceiling in the commander's room. Ugh. Food paste machine. Hologram. Ooh, industrial fan. That might go back here, guys. No animation. That's unfortunate. Industrial bits. Not quite the machine I'm looking for, though. I'm looking for like a, I don't know, AC duct or something to just go against the ceiling. What is this? Oh, it's just all kinds of industrial machines nonstop, it looks like. Institute stuff. Jet engine. Ooh. Light on a red chain. Ancient metal. Okay. Oh, there's all kinds of like levers and gears and stuff like that. Guys, I'm gonna have so much fun detailing this. Be glad you're not gonna see all of it. It's going to take forever. Okay, guys, I'm gonna take this rooftop greeble right here, which of course is far too large. I'm gonna select it in the console. Set scale, let's do 0.5. And then grab it again. Now it is much, much smaller. What I'm seeing, though, is a definite problem. Yeah, I have to scratch that idea, guys. The collision mesh was still full size, so I actually could not walk through the room once I'd placed that, because even though I had resized the piece itself, the game still thought that it was full size as it was when I first placed it. So it was blocking the whole room. Well, while I'm looking at IVs and stuff like that, might as well put one of these over here in the medical lab for later. Okay, so what can I put up there? Well, I can put a plant in here at least. Not a big one, though. Okay. Let's also put a nice ceiling fan to keep the air going. Keep it from getting stuffy for the commander. And hopefully that still leaves enough room for some kind of something right there to cover it up. Although, you know what, guys? That could almost be like an air vent that's just awkwardly placed in between the wood sections. It's not that big of a deal, and seeing I can't find a good piece that will fit it, I think I'll leave it be. It's going to be more distracting to have something trying to close that gap than to just leave it as it is. Chalkboard. That's something useful. I'm going to actually store the Minutemen flag. I'll put it partially on top of those posters, and instead I'll have a chalkboard for the commander to use in his quarters, along with a wall clock somewhere, maybe? Is that actually on the wall? Let's shrink that down. Much better. Everything in this bunker is going to have to be very compact. And of course, a file tray. And a stack of unblemished papers for our busy commander. I'll put it off to the side here. Oh yeah, the fire panels, like on the Pridwin. I'm gonna have these at a couple of different vault areas, including, of course, the kitchen and the main quarters, and if it'll fit. Yes, it will, in the reactor room. Maybe one down here, too. Hey, the ductwork actually fits pretty well. Probably don't need a radio in the commander's quarters. But if I could find a few other items, like his very own thermostat, some clean towels, let's do a trash can. Again, a crowded quarters, but still a very neat one. Is that clock floating? That clock is floating. And now I've gone and knocked the trash can over. I'm gonna scoot that into place with place everywhere, no pun intended. So it's not floating off the wall, and yes, that does bother me when stuff does that. I'm going to avoid the trash can for now because it's just going to keep falling over. Oh, classical radio. That's nice. Caution, wet floor. Ah. a stop floor sign for the check-in. That makes sense. A fake terminal. Or is this actually a real terminal? I think it's fake. That actually makes more sense than a typewriter, I think. For the commander of the bunker. Good grief, it's huge, though. And I think that'll come close to doing it for the main personal effects, or the main large props, that is. Clothes hanger with the military uniform on it. Again, you've got to make use of your space here. Speaking of space, there's no wardrobe or any kind of clothes storage in here. Let's get rid of that Minutemen painting and let's think. If storage and space was at a premium, where might clothes and articles like that be stored? Place down the ammo container there. That's a cool prop. And a desk file with actual files in it. I forget which prop mod this is, but I like it. Hard part about selecting something to place is that when you're inside of a fake mountain, it wants to click on everything. Okay, for the clothes, I'm wondering if I could perhaps glitch a wardrobe into the wall like it's built-in storage? And what kind of stuff is this? That must be new vault stuff. That's cool. Yeah, let's look at the wardrobe, guys. That and a few personal effects will seal the deal, I think, for the commander's quarters. Well, there's this cabinet, but that's metal and does not really fit in with the look of the room. There's this cabinet, which actually fits okay. Could fit right there. But let me look and see if this built-in cabinet idea is worth looking at first. Yeah, guys, this looks kind of cool. If I glitch it into the wall, can two fit? Oh, can I grab it again? Gotta go through. Okay, I'm gonna place two of them, scale them at like 80%, and then I should actually be able to fit two of them here. So let's place our first one, select it, set scale, 0.8. Oh, command SETI scale not found. Set scale 0.8. And nothing was selected. There we go. So if I glitch this into the wall, and let's go ahead and get our second one. I think that would look like really cool built-in, like, vault shelving that would just go back into the rock face. So I'll start with this one. And I'm going to hide the top shelf. Just make the curved design part of the wall, basically. Now this really is submarine style right here, guys. Well, my first guess was right. That's not quite lined up. We're very close though. And there we have it, built-in dresser storage for the discerning Vault Commander. And just because I'm really enjoying the design of this room, guys, I'm going to finish the last couple of details, one of which is going to be, let's go to Settlement Keywords Extended, Artwork, vertical pinups. Looking for some rough graffiti. Pleasure Island. Let's see. Large posters. No, small posters. Revelation. What's this? Revelation 21:6. Can I actually select that? Set scale. Probably 0.7. Yes! We can fit it on the board. Now that is cool. I think there was a mushroom cloud, too. Get well soon. Steve was here, you suck. Have it like someone took some chalk and doodled on the commander's chalkboard. Although I guess this might actually be mine, now that the Minutemen control it. Okay, that's too much fun. Steve was here. And let's put that Minutemen flag back on the wall. Although the come and take it flag is tempting, I'm going to go with a classic Minutemen flag to... Oh, I put it in the wall, didn't I? Oh, there it is. To cover up the vault posters. I'm going to scale it down just a bit, though, and fit it right there. Okay, there's our flag in place. Can I turn the radio on? Well, surprise, surprise, no signal in the bunker. Let's look through here. I'm not going to do any sign passes because, as you guys can see, my science category is nuts. It scrolls for like 10 minutes. But I did see my join or die poster there. Where did that go? Nah, let's not get too crazy with posters in here. It's already getting a bit crowded in the detailing department. Let's stay focused, go to OC Decorator and place our last couple of personal effect props. Generic holo tape. I think perhaps one over here on the radio too. A golden lighter. That seems correct. Let's turn surface snapping back on. A silver locket. Military ammo bag. I've got the ammo box right there. But I'll just hide an extra bag of ammo underneath the bed. A wedding ring. Just a fake one, of course, but I think I'll pass on that prop. A golden stopwatch. Don't need cleaning supplies. Oh, a bowl for dog meat, though. Probably best served, no pun intended, in the cafeteria. Alarm clock, that fits, though. Put it behind the bed here. Don't really need the desk fan because we have the ceiling fan. Ah, the telephone. Useful for calling in from the front door or out to the front door. An extra pillow because I am the general. Umbrella stand. Only got 5 of those left. Empty vase. No real room for that kind of thing in here, including the flowers. That leaves for entertainment. An iBot model. A Protectron model. That's cool. I'm gonna set a couple of these up on my shelf below the flag here. Like the commander before me had a particular hobby even after the atomic bombs fell. Got a bunch of these now. Robot parts model. I must have found those during the Automatron campaign. That's cool. A good place for them. And seeing this is a bunker that looks like it was built by Vault-Tec. The barter bobblehead, that's just too perfect. Is there room up here on this shelf? Does that count as a shelf? It's close. But yeah, that counts as a shelf. Put our good friend right on the edge. Okay guys, let me turn off the UI so you guys can see. Is there a door in here yet? Okay, let's turn the UI back on, add a door, and then we'll take a look at our commander's quarters for my secret bunker project. I'm gonna call this basically complete. So much for, I don't detail everything on the Let's Build videos. Okay, occasionally I will. Mainly because this was far too much fun. Okay, so that's Overseer wall doorway. So I think if I go to Overseer's room, was there an actual door meant for that? Nope. Well, that's alright, instead of trying to figure out what snaps where. Thanks to the power of the Place Everywhere mod, I can just put this door wherever I want it and just make it look good. Now making it work well, that is a whole different story. Okay. Well, that's close enough. Let's turn off that UI again and take a look. Close that door back. So you'll come either through the access passageway in the reactor room or the cafeteria to the lowest section of the vault with the medical area. Got the toys and the smaller Minutemen flag. Awkwardly clipped power coupling. Our work area. Really liking that wooden shelved integrated storage. That looks pretty awesome. And let's not forget the underground cave. And then just some personal effects back here on the wall. Well guys, I hope you see the kind of theme that I'm going for this build. As you can tell, I'm having a lot of fun with this. Hope you guys are too. Thanks for watching. Keep those suggestions and tips coming, and I'll see you guys on the next video.